Hi, welcome to RG Lecture. So this channel is dedicated to the students of physics, and this particular playlist of AC circuit contains all the videos which are a part of syllabus of graduation level physics. It can be BSc physics, physics honors, electronics, electrical engineering, and many such courses. So consider sharing these playlists and videos into your college and class groups. Also join my Telegram group, link is given in the description. Hi, in this video we will discuss the concept of power, power dissipation, power factor, apparent power and so on for the resistor, inductor, capacitor and everything. This video can be for a class 12 student, can be for a BSc student, can be for an engineering student, because we will not use complex number here, we will use integration, so anyone can watch them. So let's start. Now what is power? Now we are using circuit, we are connecting appliances, we are taking some voltage, so definitely they will consume some amount of power. Now what is power? Power is simply the voltage which we apply times the current, right? Whatever our electric bill is calculated by this formula only, okay? So this is the power, basic formula. Everything was fine when we were using DC circuits, but now voltage here in the now case is changing with respect to time. My current is changing with respect to time. Everything is E is E naught sine omega t. I is I naught sine omega t. So power will also change with time. So that is why we need to redefine few things. So you can consider anything. You can start with I is equals to the I naught sine omega t. And consider V is equals to the V naught sine omega t plus phi, minus phi, anything. You can take this, you can take that. Just we have to derive the general case, right? In general case, we consider there is a phase difference. In reality, if there is no phase difference, we will remove the term phi. So here in this case, I am deriving by using these two terms. You can derive by any way you want. So P is equals to the VI, V is E naught sine omega t, my I is equals to the I naught sine omega t plus minus phi, multiply sine omega t with let us separate all the terms and expand this equation first. So this is sine a plus b, which equals to sine a cos b plus cos a sine b. Okay, so in the second step I have written this. So this is my a, this is my b. So sine a cos b cos a sine b, plus minus is common, multiply sine omega t by this, so this will become sine square omega t cos phi, multiplying by this it will become this. So this is my expression for power. Let us calculate the average power. I have told various times that this is the integral for if you want to calculate average of any term, 0 to t the function itself, 0 to t the time. So denominator, if I solve, so denominator integral will be simply t minus 0, which is equivalent to t. So let us focus now on the numerator because it is somewhat lengthy. Okay, so this was my numerator which I had written in the last few steps. So this is a constant term which will go outside. Divide the integral in two sections, integrate this separately, integrate this separately, it will be easy. So cos of phi, phi is not dependent on time, so phi will go outside the integral. Integration of sine square omega t, integration of cos square omega t is half. Okay, whatever the term is, it is half. So here, since I have limit, so it will become t by 2. You can solve them separately. This is a fixed and common value. Okay, so this integration is half. This integration will be 0. Cos omega t dot sine omega t integration is 0. Here is the proof. Sine of 2 theta can be written as 2 sine theta into cos theta. Right? So remove the 2 and throw it here. So basically sine of theta cos of theta can be written as sine 2 theta by 2. So sine 2 theta by 2. So 2 and 2 will get cancelled. Sine of theta in the video of RMS, in the video of average value, we have already calculated that sine of theta over a full cycle is equals to 0. Right? In the average value video we have done. Right? It is 0. So basically this whole term is 0. So here I am left with E0 I0 cos of phi. And here I have this t by 2, and already this was the numerator. In denominator I had 1t. Okay, so let's write all this. T gets cancelled, so basically I get e naught I naught by 2, here this is the 2, times cos of phi. I can write e naught by root 2, I naught by root 2 because root of 2 is 2. So basically this becomes ERMS, this becomes IRMS, this becomes cos phi. So this is my average value of power in an AC circuit. This is the general expression. Of course, in graduation, it is not expected to derive the formulas, but it is my duty to tell you. What is apparent power? So apparent power means what we considered that it must be. So apparently we know that P is equals to dVi. So if we remove the term of cos of phi, so basically this is called as apparent power, right? We have an apparent position of star, we have apparent position of objects. So in the same way, apparent power, nothing much important in that. I know cos of phi is r by z. If I draw the, this is r, this is xl, this is z, right, in the impedance phasor or the impedance triangle. So what is cos of theta? Cos of phi, what is phi? Cos of phi, it is OHAH adjacent, which is r upon hypotenuse. So adjacent is r, hypotenuse is z. So I can write r by z. What is v? V is equals to the I square r, or v rms for the whole circuit is equals to the I into z, I rms into z. So zz will get cancelled, and this is the expression. Also I is equals to the v by z, right? V by z. So I can substitute this. So from this equation I can derive two equations by just using this equation. So you can use any equation of power in any sum. So write all these three in the notebooks. It can be used anywhere. All three are the same form, nothing much as far as the physics is concerned. Cos of phi is called as power factor. Okay, it is called as power factor. So basically I can write true power is equals to the apparent power multiplied by power factor. This is the equation, this, and power factor is equals to the true power upon ratio of true power to apparent power. Okay, and so this was all the theory concept. So essentially what you need to remember, the most important equation is this only. Okay, if we want to find the power, let's find from this equation. Now let's find in the case of a resistor. Okay, let's find in the case of resistor. We know that in a resistor, these three things we know, right? 10 times we have done in this playlist. So phase difference is 0. So cos of phi will be 1, because cos of 0 is equals to the 1. So what will be P? P will be equal to these two quantities. Substitute the value of I0 as V0 by R. So you will get V0 square upon 2R. This is the thing I have done here. Okay, same thing is done with the earlier formula, right? I had used this form. Just a second. I had used this form in the lower section and I had used this form in the upper section. You can use any, but use one form only. Go for this equation. Answer will be the same in both the equations. V0 square upon 2R is the power when a resistor is connected to the AC circuit. In case of an inductor or in case of a capacitor, the power is 0. It is 0. Why? Because there is a phase difference of 90 degrees, and cos of 90 degrees is equal to 0. So basically, because of power factor is 0, so everything is 0. But when? Only in one complete cycle. Only in one complete cycle. So basically, in inductor, the average power over one complete cycle is 0. So therefore, an inductor is called as non-dissipative energy storing element. Okay, so it is easy to conclude mathematically that power consumed by an inductor is 0 in the complete cycle. But actually, what is actually happening? How can a substance cannot consume any power if it is working? My question is, how can a substance cannot consume any power if it is working? So yes, it consumes power. It consumes power. So let average power delivered by the source to inductor in first quarter be cycle be P1 and the other be to P2. Okay, because everything is connected across voltage. So let P1 be the power delivered in the first cycle, half cycle, and the P2 within the other half cycle. So now let us try to find the integrals from half quarter. Okay, in the half quarter, see, I know the power is 0 from this to this. Okay, so let me try to find the power from delivered from 0 to T by 4. And when you calculate the power in this section only, from 0 to t by 2, 0 to t by 4, this is t by 4, and from t by 4 to t by 2, you get the values of power. I have not done the integration here because it will kill the physics. I want to focus on the physics in this video. Okay, so therefore I am not doing. So just power, if integrated with this limits, gives us the value V0I0 by pi minus sign. So from this to this, our power is minus V0I0 by pi. From T by 4 to T by 2, our power is V0I0 by pi. And if you calculate the average power over a half cycle, then it will become 0 because this is in minus, this is plus. So if over once half cycle it is 0, so over another half cycle it will be 0, so 0 plus 0 will be 0. But in 1/4 of a cycle it is not 0. So what is the conclusion? Power is not 0 in quarter cycle, it is 0 in half, so eventually it is 0 in the full cycle. What does this mean? Minus power means power is delivered from the inductor to source, and plus means it is delivered from the source to inductor. So basically, if inductor stores the energy in the form of electrical energy, so when it is storing the electrical energy, power is given from the source to inductor. When the inductor has sufficient energy, it gives powers back to the source. So this continues. So net average power over one cycle is zero, but in a quarter cycle it is not zero. So current in purely inductive circuit is said to be worthless because eventually power is zero. That is the true point. Okay, in class 12th, this reason is not stated, but in graduation it is stated. Same situation as inductor, nothing to explain. Power in the first 1/4 of a cycle is in minus, in the other it is in plus. Capacitor is being charged in first half of the cycle, in the rest half of the cycle it discharges. So charging, discharging, charging, discharging, power taken, power given, power taken, power given. So basically same situation, power average is again zero over a full cycle. But for arbitrary circuits where L is connected with R, C is connected with R, phase difference is neither zero nor 90, because you know, in ideally this is the case, but in circuits like this when things are combined, so phase difference is not zero. So there, then power depends on the values of R, L and C, because cos of phi becomes R by Z, right? Z itself is equal to the R square plus XL square. XL is considered of omega L. So basically then power depends upon the value of RL Z because of the term cos of phi. If this is 1, VN, I are in phase. Okay, VN, I are in phase because when cos of phi will be 1? When R is, what is Z? Z is equal to the R square plus XL square. So basically when it will be 1? When it will be R by R. When Z be R, when Z will be equal to R, when this term is 0, when this term is 0, when there is resonance, right? What is Z? Z is equal to the R square plus XL minus XC square, or XC minus XL square, right? So basically if XL minus XC or XC minus XL, so if these terms are 0, then it is said to be resonance condition. Okay, that's all you need to know about power. I hope this concept was clear to you. Okay, so that's it. See you in the next video. I hope you enjoy this video. Keep sharing with your friends. This video, this channel is dedicated for the students of BSc Physics. There are very few channels for BSc Physics which provide quality education. So since I have started an initiative, so do support me by sharing this video. See you in the next video.